Well, hello and welcome to Outdoor Oklahoma. I'm Todd Craighead. The year 2020 is certainly one that will go down in the books, including the record book. In a five-month span, Keystone Lake produced a string of record-breaking size paddlefish, which included a new lake record, a new state record, an unofficial world record, and not one, but two new official world records, and countless other triple-digit fish. Here's the story of the Keystone paddlefish records.
This is the personal best for my son. He caught an 85-pound spoonbill, and that was his best one. And we've caught a few other ones, and then about the 10th one we caught, it was the 151 pounds, 14.4 ounces.
My name is Corey Waters, and I'm the world's record holder for paddlefish on Keystone Lake, weighing in at 151.9 pounds.
151.9.
Yeah!
Yes. Good job! You
got it. Paddlefish are such a neat fish. They get big, they're primitive, and anything that gets big and is as bizarre looking as a paddlefish is, that kind of stuff is just intuitively attractive to people.
So here's some of our fishing trips from all throughout the year. We've had a lot of big fish here caught. A triple digit fish, they're not very common. Keystone has produced several of these triple digit fish. It's not uncommon for each trip that we go out to produce a triple digit fish. My name is Jeremiah Mefford. I'm the owner operator of Real Good Time Guide Service here on Keystone Lake. I've been guiding here since February of 2020. Since then, I've been very blessed. We've actually landed four fish that have been current or possible new world records. Two of them are official. One of them came in at 146, the other one was 151.9.
We know that paddlefish in Keystone Lake have been large for some time. You've got genetic influences, you've got ecological influences, physiological. Yeah, it all kind of comes together potentially in influencing the growth of paddlefish in Keystone Lake. And the results of that we're seeing now with anglers snagging massive fish, not only massive fish, but world record paddlefish in one lake in Oklahoma in a fairly restricted time period.
Keystone Lake, a 23,600 acre reservoir upstream from Tulsa, is home to world-class size paddlefish. In fact, in 2020 alone, anglers boated dozens of triple-digit sized paddlefish, making records, breaking records, and breaking records again. This is the story of Keystone Lake's record-breaking frenzy. It was Friday, February 14th, 2020. Justin Hamlin of Kellyville snagged and boated a 157-pound paddlefish from the bow of guide Jeremiah Mefford's boat. At that time, the hook and line world record was a 144-pound paddlefish from a watershed pond in Kansas, caught in 2004. But since Hamlin's 157-pounder was caught on a mandatory catch and release day, a legal, certified weight could not be used. So, although by all accounts this was the biggest paddlefish ever caught, it could not be called the world record. Talk about a Valentine's heartbreaker. More than 3 months later, guide Jeremiah Mefford once again saw a record class fish enter his boat, as he himself landed one weighing 143 pounds. That fish broke the Oklahoma state record by 10.5 pounds. 1 month later, on June 28th, James Lucard of Edmond bested Mefford's catch with a new world record fish weighing an incredible 146.7 pounds. But amazingly, that record didn't last long, because on July 23rd, Corey Waters of Oshaleda landed a new world record fish weighing 151.9 pounds.
151.9. Yeah.
Incredibly, all four record fish were caught from Jeremiah Mefford's boat on Keystone Lake.
We started after the world record fish, which we didn't know it at the time, and we finally got a hook in it. And I started reeling it in, and it started getting closer and closer to the boat. And Jeremiah, he was excited. He was like, this is a big fish. Like he was about ready to jump on the water because he was so excited.
We knew it was big. We knew it was big. It wasn't until it came up and out of the water that we realized just the sheer size of that fish. Soon as it came out and it topped the water for the first time after a several minute long fight, I knew right then and there, we probably had the new world record fish.
And the wife, she put a lot of the articles that everybody's wrote about it, some of the interviews I've had on it, and then also a lot of the Facebook comments. That's kind of neat to look at. With the tag of it.
Not only was it a giant fish, and it's great for Oklahoma to boast that world record paddlefish, but it has a really cool conservation story in that it had a band on it, a tag, that was placed by a paddlefish researcher back in the late 1990s.
So my name is Craig Pockert, and I'm the leader of the Missouri Cooperative Fish and Wildlife Research Unit at the University of Missouri, and I'm also a cooperative professor at MU. I actually got my start with paddlefish at Oklahoma State University, where I was getting my master's degree at the Oklahoma Cooperative Fish and Wildlife Research Unit at OSU, and that was actually tagging paddlefish and trying to understand their biology in Keystone Lake outside of Tulsa. At the time, in the mid-90s, ODWC really didn't know how many fish were in the lake and how abundant they were. So my job as a master's student was to go out there and net fish, determine the size and abundance of the fish, and then we tagged some fish as well to look for recaptures and determine where they went to potentially spawn.
My name's Brandon Brown. I'm the paddlefish program coordinator for the Paddlefish Research Center up at the north end of Grand Lake by my AMA. Back years ago when I was at OSU as an undergrad, I worked on with Craig Pockert, who was getting his master's degree. I don't remember how many fish we tagged back in 96 and 97, but it was many. And kind of forgot about those fish.
Yeah, so this was just really bizarre. Probably one of the highlights of my career, really, to have this happen. So I was just sitting at my desk, that morning, and I get a phone call from a newspaper in Tulsa. And they said, you don't know me, but apparently someone on Keystone Reservoir just caught a fish that you tagged. And I was dumbfounded because this was 20 some years ago. So after doing some digging, found out the tag number from the angler, and that ODWC went down there and was weighing the fish and measuring the fish and certifying it. And it ended up that I looked through my files and it was a fish I tagged on January 4th, 1997. And it was around 7.7 pounds and 24 inches long when we tagged it. And lo and behold, 23 years later, it was 151 pounds. So it was really neat to see that come full circle.
It's kind of funny how things come full circle. I had never seen a paddlefish before. I worked for Craig. Never, when I got out of college, I never thought, at that time, there weren't any jobs working with paddlefish. It was just this weird grad project that Craig had. And, you go down the road 15 or 20 years, and I'm working with our paddlefish program up at Miami. 10 years later, we're catching the world record paddlefish out of Keystone Lake that Craig and I likely tagged together, back in January in 1997.
Just the probability of that happening is so low. And to see that fish that was caught in a research net 23 years ago now is holding the title of the world record paddlefish is pretty spectacular.
As Oklahomans, we absolutely should be proud of this, of the fishery, of the world record catch. Our fishery here is exceptional compared to other states. We are really fortunate to have what we have here. And a lot of other places would really like to have what we have. We won the paddlefish lottery, so to speak.
Do I think there's bigger fish to be caught? I do. I don't think that world record's gonna last long at 151.9.
It would not surprise me in the slightest if we break the world record again. However, seeing a continuation of sort of a record-breaking frenzy where it's just month after month after month, we have a new record. I think those days may be limited.
All these current world records, they're still in the lake and they're still good and healthy.
Will the record ever be broken again? And will it come from Keystone again? It's not quite out of the question. Someone will catch another world-class paddlefish. Now, if you're fortunate enough to catch a large paddlefish, it's important that you know how to properly catch and release one of these giants.
All right, so we're out here at one of our first spots here. We're gonna try to locate a big paddlefish. Once we've located this big paddlefish, we're gonna go after it and we're gonna catch her. Once we've caught her, I'm gonna demonstrate real quickly on a real quick catch and release method to handle these fish and get them back into the water safely. That is crucial to the survival of these fish and to make sure that Keystone Lake or any other lake that has paddlefish continues this great fishery the Oklahoma Wildlife Department has made it.
Oh, she ain't happy, buddy. All right, big. Real. There we go. Real, bud. Nice. There we go. Got her. All right, keep her tight. Tight. That'll boy. Good. Good job, Brody. Good job, buddy.
You have to use a barbless hook. You're not allowed to have barbs on these hooks. We're using anywhere from 2.5 to 6 ounce weights, depending on how the fish are reacting from one day to the next. And the biggest thing is to keep that line tied at all times, because you've got a massive weight pulling down on a barbless hook. So if these fish get slack, that hook slides right out of them. I'm gonna actually help him out now. That fish took a lot of line. We're actually gonna chase it down. On the bigger fish, when I know they're over 100 pounds, keep that rod tip up, buddy. Keep it up, real. If I know that the fish are over 100 pounds, I will, most of the time, I will chase down, I'll chase them down with the trolling motor. There's two reasons I like to do that. One, and one that's real important to me, is that by fighting that fish all the way from 80 yards out to 100 yards out, all the way back to the boat, it puts a lot of unwanted stress on that fish. The odds of survival obviously go down. These are very hardy fish, but anything you could do to help that stress of that fish out really goes a long way for these fish, especially during the summertime. The other part of that is if it does get fortunate enough to get away from us, I like the opportunity to maybe find that fish again. So I'll stay up on it with the trolling motor for those two reasons right there. Always be prepared to get that fish on board. Have your scales ready, have your phones ready to take some really quick pictures. If you're gonna bring it aboard, make it quick, get that fish back in the water as fast as you can. Rod tip up, come on buddy, put that rod to work. Good. So that fish is gonna be in the 70 pound range there. I try to keep my out of water time to about a minute. If we can keep it under a minute, especially when it's hot, we've done it right. And a big part of that is just being prepared. When you bring it aboard, just be ready and prepared. So at this point, you want to keep a little pressure on that line. And these fish have a tendency to take off if I don't get them this first time. So I'm going to have him keep pressure on that line. Just like that. There she goes. We're going to keep her right here. All right, buddy. Let's try this again. And we got her that time. And that's how easy that hook pops out. It just comes right out just like that because it's barbless. What we're gonna do now is I'm gonna bring her to the back of the boat and we're gonna go ahead and get our scales ready. So he's gonna get his scales, and this is a good point. Leave them in the water. Let them recover a little bit here. We're gonna get our scale on. We're gonna make sure it's in the right unit. And this is a good point if you're gonna take pictures to go ahead and have your phones ready. Have it in camera mode. That way when we get this fish on board, we're gonna have her out as little as we possibly can. We'll get a quick weight, take a couple quick pictures, get them right back in the water. You're gonna see that whenever we release this fish, the best thing to do is to take them and a nose dive straight in. You don't want them landing on their sides or on their belly. You just want to kind of get their nose pointing straight down. That way they get a good release, get back into the water. 99% of the time these fish swim off just fine. But if you ever see that fish up, it could be one of two things. It went under a lot of stress and it's still a little stressed out, or its air bladder could be full. What you're gonna see when I pull this fish in, I give it just a second on the side of the boat and it's gonna put pressure on its belly and you're gonna hear the air come out of this fish. By allowing that air to come out of that fish, it's gonna allow her to go back down to the depths of the water. So here we go. He's got the scale ready. This is the part where I kind of burp them a little bit. Come up. Sometimes you hear them burp, sometimes you don't, but I'll leave them right there for a second. This fish is actually gonna be in the 80-pound range. So I'm gonna bring her aboard. We're gonna work real quick here. I'm gonna have my rope ready to go for another girth wrap right here around the rostrum. I'm gonna come up over the top. I'm gonna take our scale. She's in the 80s. We're gonna get a quick weight.
86 pounds.
So we got an 86 pound. I'll hand him a scale. At this point, I would lift this fish up, hand it to somebody from this position. I just lift it up into their arms. They're gonna cradle it, take a few good pictures, release her back in. But for right now, we're not gonna take any pictures. So we're just gonna get this 86 pound fish back into the water. So I'll release her. She's coming off the edge. Remember, you want head first. And there she goes. And that's how it's done. Good job.
One of the main reasons we're witnessing the catch of large fish is because of new sonar technology such as the Garmin Livescope, which delivers live, real-time scanning of the fish swimming below. Up next, we're going to take you to Broken Bow Lake as we showcase some hot wintertime fishing action using Livescope.
Today we're on Broken Bow Lake. Today we're going to be trying to catch of various types of species, sand bass, crappie, largemouth, spotted bass, all on jigging spoons. We're going to be going out here in the middle of the lake trying to find certain types of humps that I've been catching these fish on.
What we have here is a couple of wads of shad, bait fish. These streaks are fish that are actively feeding on them right now. So when you find that, that's usually a good sign.
Today I'll be using a live scope, helping us detect these fish and seeing how they are reacting to our baits and if they're aggressive. What this does, it really just helps us put the right depth and where the fish are suspended at. So we'll be playing around with that a little bit today.
How deep was he?
He was about 40 foot. Not a bad way to start off.
Oh, crappie. Nice one.
Another crappie, Mike.
Yep, we found a school of crappie, looks like.
Mm-hmm. There goes my bait. Okay, right here is my bait. You can see it kind of moving. We got some fish already around it. But right here is a school of crappie that just kind of submerged down there, not moving very fast. My knowledge, when they're not moving very fast, it's usually always crappie. Those sand bass and hybrids, they're constantly coming through the screen, but that's a wad of crappie right there. Hopefully we'll get in some more of that. Same coming up, man.
Yeah, I got another.
Oh, I got me a Kentucky.
It may be foul hooked. It feels like it's kind of pulling that way.
Yeah.
No? I don't know. He just pulled like a big one.
right. Jigging spoons, you just let it go all the way down to the bottom. And when you feel bottom, a little slack in your line, you'll reel it up a couple times. And you'll just kind of jerk up and down. And some of them will just hit it real hard, and some of it will be just a real slight peck. And some of the slightest peck ones end up being some of the bigger fish that we end up catching sometimes. Well, right there, I just put one right on top of his nose and kind of bounce it up and down. You bet it, you can see him coming up on top right there. He's one of those head shakers, Mike. Yeah, got me a Sandy. Hopefully they'll get bigger. See it going down. And I'm going all the way to the bottom. He's already hit it. There's a bunch of them down
there.
How are
you? Get him at time.
Yep, me too. We got a double.
Another small one. I imagine probably all of them in that school are about the same size.
Yeah, they're stacked in there. Yeah, this guy a little bit bigger shoulders on him.
Yeah. Oh, there's another. Oh, nice one. They saw them little ones up here eating and they run them off, didn't
yep.
they? Yep. There he is, dang.
You got a good one.
Oh, man.
What you got?
Well, I don't know.
It come off.
Yeah, blame it.
Got me a spot. Nice spot. I noticed when we're catching them, Mike, that some of these fish are spitting out shad, and I'm sure that's chumming them up down there to make them bite, too.
Maybe. Another Kentucky.
There you go. Got one coming up. Got it, we missed it. There we go, they got it. Now look at all of them coming up.
Yeah.
They're following it. Look at that, Mike.
Yeah.
That's what we've been catching.
Yeah.
This is a big old Broken Bow Lake sand bass.
They get big in here, don't they?
They do.
I've been using the spooning technique for probably 25 years. I've been fishing the lake ever since it's been here. But I didn't really start doing this until 20-something years ago. And once I discovered it, I loved it. I've routinely told people I can catch more fish in the wintertime on Broken Bow than I can in the summer.
There he is.
There he is. I like these double hookups.
Yeah, we got a smaller one that time.
I did too.
Hey, thanks for watching today. Whether you're chasing world records or just taking advantage of the great fishing around the state, we hope that you remember that the outdoors are always open. For all of us at your wildlife department, I'm Todd Craighead, and we'll see you right back here somewhere new next time on Outdoor Oklahoma.